Okay, I just want to give you a little bit of help setting this up if you're struggling with this particular problem. So it's talking about Lance, and he takes the same amount of time to cycle 36 kilometers with a 3 kilometer per hour wind at his back as that it takes him to travel to cycle 24 kilometers if he's got that same wind in his face. So if you think about the wind is coming at your face, it's slowing you down from your regular speed. If the wind is coming at your back, it's speeding you up at your regular speed. So what we're going to do, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make a little table, right? So I know that rate times time is equal to distance. Well, in this problem, they're talking about the times being the same. So I'm going to use the time is the distance divided by the rate. And my times are going to be the same because that's what it's talking about. So I'm going to talk about the wind being at his back, and I'm going to talk about the wind being at his face, right? So let's talk about his rate and his distance and then his time. So when the wind is at his back, it's making him go faster, right? So if his speed is x, his rate with it at his back is x plus 3. The distance he can travel is 36 kilometers. And the expression for the time, I take the distance and I divide it by the rate. So it's just 36 divided by x plus 3. Now, when Lance is traveling, cycling, the wind is at his face, slowing him down. He still has his same speed x, but he is subtracting that wind speed, right? The distance he's going is 24. So the time is going to be distance, 24, divided by the rate of x minus 3. So the question is, what's his rate if these different distances take the same amount of time? So I would set this up by saying 36 over x plus 3 is 24 divided by x minus 3. So now you'll be able to solve that a little bit easier if you needed this little help.